Welcome to McConnell's Friends. Here, you will learn about the different wildlife from the three different habitats, woodland, meadow, and forest. First, you will learn about the woodlands. The woodlands is filled with many different animals. I'm just going to talk about the two main animals you see in these woodlands, turtles and dragonflies. First, we have the turtles. The type of turtles we have in McConnell's Friends are red-eared spiders and snapping turtles. They are very curious creatures. The red-eared spider shell has a very neat texture, with a yellow spot scattered all around it. They also have very sharp claws with very little yellow stripes on them. Red-eared spiders are the most commonly traded turtle in the world. They are also native to the United States and Mexico. Here, we have a red-eared spider going under this rock. He looks troubled, and I wonder why he's doing such a thing. While he's going under the rock, we see blue darting dragonflies swarming over the rock. The turtle eventually comes out of the rock. Across the woodland pond, we see other turtles on this big tree ledge that appears to be floating. The turtles look like they're hanging out together. I wonder if the ledge is actually their main habitat. Moving on, we have some dragonflies. Lots of them like to fly by the long grasses. First, we have the 12-spotted skimmer. It has brown spotted wings, which is how the name, the 12-spotted skimmer, came about. The wings also have some white spots, which develop with age. And the powder on the thorax of the dragonfly is a common feature among them. The next dragonfly we have is the widow skimmer. It is a large dragonfly that has a wingspan up to 8 centimeters. This widow skimmer hasn't fully developed yet, but adult widow skimmers usually have wings that are dark at the base, white in the middle, and transparent at the tip. Overall, dragonflies themselves have really good eyesight, are the most ancient of living creatures, and are completely homeless. So, that is all about the two animals in the woodland and McConnell's Friends. But that's not all the animals. Besides the woodland group, we have the middle group. First, we have this crested butterfly. This pearl crescent is on the flower and is sucking on nectar. That's why you see butterflies on flowers. They suck nectar just like honeybees. The next animal I saw in the middle is a dogbane beetle. These beetles have a special type of color that changes as the insect changes position. And finally, the last animal I saw in the middle was a ladybug. He is sitting on his large leaf, and he looks like he bit on a leaf. Ladybugs are very small beetles. They range from 0.8 to 18 millimeters. The most common ladybugs are red and have black spots. Sadly, those were all the animals I could find in the meadow. The final group in McConnell's Friends is the forest. Like the meadow, it was hard to find these curious creatures. The first animal I found was by the final sink stream. It was a blue jay drying and drinking off water from a bath. Blue jays like to live in forests, and it gets food from trees, shrubs, and the ground. Next, I saw this group of minnows, which are very tiny fish that live in streams or creeks. They were in a blue hole, a deep blue-green pool that flows 100 feet beneath the ledge. The last thing I saw in the forest was called the boils, which was a stream. Usually after it rains, it boils. So that was all the animals from the forest group. When I was going back to the van, I saw some various plants and a butterfly that was hidden in the trees. So that concludes our adventure at McConnell's Friends. The animals were very interesting to see, and I hope you're doing something about them. Bye!